Now I invite our special guest, Professor Dr. Abdul Mannan, the Honorable Vice Chancellor of Hamdard University Bangladesh.
Chairman of the inaugural session of 4th Al-Biruni Interdisciplinary Conference, Dr. Abu Musa Mohammad, Arif Billah, and Professor Dr. Abdul Latif Samian, National University Malaysia, Professor Dr. Majid Gajor, Isfahan Science and Technology University, Barrister Ahmed Abdul Malik, scholars, presenters, participants, students, Assalamu Alaikum. To talk about Al-Biruni, we just ask someone who does not know how to swim to cross the English Channel. But in any way, I'll try to say something which may not be on the basis of his works, but what is my thinking about it, what I'm thinking. But I start with quoted by Dr. Majid Gajar from George Sharton and Gafurov, that he was one of the greatest scientists of Islam, and of course, the greatest of all times. And then, the second one is, his brilliant discoveries, incomprehensible to most of the scholars of his days. So this two quotations from two persons, as quoted by Professor Gajar, is giving me some light to talk about him, mainly to see how he is relevant even today and will continue to be relevant, and what we are, what we are doing, what we should do. Of course, we know that he was an astronomer, he was a mathematician, philosopher, and he was studying natural sciences, physics, and so on. He was a traveler, he was a scholar, he was an intellectual, and who was curious virtually in all fields of knowledge that had been available at his time. So he was so versatile that he was trying to be everywhere in terms of acquiring knowledge or inventing knowledge. Another thing in his character was, he engaged with scholarship he encountered on spot. As one of the scholars was quoting about Koitillo. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
One of the mathematician, Indian mathematician. Then he was also an accountant. He was also suggested how to do business. And I believe there is a profound influence of Koitillo on Al-Biruni, or I'm not sure whether Al-Biruni influenced him. And that's the reason he became Koitillo of Indo-Pak subcontinent at that time. So that's what I'm saying. Where he went, he started, encountered anything on the spot. He did not leave it like us. He did not avoid it. He encountered it. And to my understanding, this is high ideal of academic culture. If you find something, if it is curious, you engage with it. Don't avoid it or leave it. That's a very good lesson for our academics, for our scholars, for our researchers nowadays. And now it is still relevant. This kind of characteristic of the academics and the scholars is still relevant after 1,000 years. Another thing I tried to find out, that Western scientists, mainly Western scientists, believe that modern scientific research initiated since 16th and 17th centuries. That was the profound saying from the Western scientists. But if you look at Biruni, his works demonstrate that centuries before he utilized several sensory, rational, critical, comparative methods of his scientific works. He carried out precise experiments on laws of gravitation, momentum, measurement of specific gravity, and precise stones and metals, calculation of arcs, as we have seen, speed and sound, etc. His accuracy and honesty, he was very honest what he was doing. He was reporting everything what he found. So his accuracy and honesty will remain ever, which is required properties of researchers. So this is a good lesson for researchers even today, that you remain accurate and remain honest. Don't go for plagiarism, don't go for reporting something which is not yours. So I think I'm not talking about his works, but something we shall have to learn from him. What we had found in the Western culture, even somebody is doing PhD, a minister in German, and then he lost his ministry, and he had to agree that it's not his works. So that's a lesson for us. Talking about the religion, when we conduct any research, there is a range of procedures and methods we use. But when we do the research, we try to understand the phenomenon in question using one or two methods. But Al-Biruni in Malil Hind has been trying to use various methods altogether. He was not satisfied with one or two methods. He tried to apply methods as many as he could. Al-Biruni formulated scientific method to the comparative study of religion about 1,000 years ago, which was long before the advance of comparative religion. When he was using the methods in studying the comparative religion between Islam, between Hinduism, between Christianity, and between what he calls the Jainism and all the religion. But he was using several methods using those. And you can see that he did it long before the comparative religion was introduced as an academic discipline. That's also a lesson for the researchers, scholars nowadays. Don't just try to remain and bog down in one methods or one areas. And you should not say that just comparative religion started yesterday. It started from Al-Biruni, that we shall have to acknowledge. Now I like to say something about, because when I want to conclude, I will say something more. The Iran, the Persian, Indo-Pak subcontinent, the Bangladesh. There was really close cultural relationships between Iran and Bangladesh since time immemorial, long time ago. During the rule of Mughals and of the early period of British rule in Bengal, Dhaka was considered to be a cradle for the development of Persian language and literature. So there was a strong ties. If you go to Bogra, and if you see the rivers there, who is dying out now, that time the sheep used to come to that place. And we have business with the Mediterranean and that part of the world. And that's the way. It's not only business, languages, cultures, and everything is massed together. It's not today, long ago, that Pundru civilization. So the ties was not today. It's long before between Iran, the Persian, and the Bengal. More, history reveals that from 13th century onward, Bengal was facilitated by the Iranian scholars as many ways, such as science, philosophy, theology, history, and culture, as I said earlier. Al-Biruni, a most profound genius among them, his Kitabus Sayyidina is a very famous book on herbal medicine. when I talk about Hamdard University, don't feel that it is only a Ayurveda and Unani. We have science, we have engineering, we have arts, and we have social sciences, everything. But we have very strong emphasis on this Unani and Ayurveda. That's why I'm quoting this one. The dead time, in that book, Al-Biruni discusses 1,000 types of local plants in this book. At that time, I believe I am not wrong, correct, my teachers are here, that we have listed about 5,000, nearly 4,000 to 5,000 plants in medicine. So, thousands of years ago, he already identified 1/4 of the total we have invented, we have discovered until today. That's the strong link between us and the Persian. Then I'm coming to my real thinking. It is true that development of science, philosophy, and all other branches of education in the medieval period was completely related to Muslim scholars such as Al-Biruni. The people of South Asia in general and Bangladesh in particular do not know much about them, if I am not wrong. It is time for us to learn about their eventful lives and individual contributions. I am sure this conference will fill the gaps and enlarge the horizon of our knowledge in the areas. That's not the end of the story. We are grateful to our great friend, who is working very hard, so far I know and so far I interacted with him last few days, Professor Billah. This is one of things of organizing a conference. Our scholars and speakers coming from Iran and other places, Malaysia, that filling us some gaps. But what is the permanent solution? What you can do? The tendency is that the universities in Bangladesh mainly, we are trying to forge our relationships with Western universities. We are looking for North America. We feel proud to be signing an MOU with any universities, even if it is offering degree meal in America, than any other part of the Persian countries. That's the problem. The few days ago, on Pahala Boishak, Sanjida Khatun, one of our greatest cultural leaders, said, try to find your root, try to understand your root, try to understand what is available there, and then you go for the others. Then you will be able to succeed. We shall have to find out what was available with us, what strong ties we have with Iran or Persian countries and us, and how we can revitalize those. During the British rule, we are taught that we should be more westernized than our part of the world, and that trend is still continuing. So, from Hamdard University, I can say one thing, what I felt, people may not like it, or some people even within my university may not like it. The first time everybody was asking to sign MOU with universities in USA and other places, I first signed an MOU with the Jamia Hamdard, Hamdard University in India. And maybe we are going to West now, Pakistan. Then I'm trying to find out our colleagues, our friends, our universities, our researchers in Iran and some other parts of that world. As Professor Adha said, the Muslim countries nowadays is trying to forget their own resources they have. And we are trying to westernize more. The universities established in Abu Dhabi, Sharjah, and other places, everybody is looking for West and trying to find students from West or East. These resources we have, even Saudi Arabia is trying to establish universities, what you call this, billions and billions of dollars they are spending. But what they're doing to bring the Easternized cultures and everything to there. They don't spend a single farthing to know what Al-Biruni said or what Ibn Sina said. So we shall change this culture. Our scholars, our universities, our governments, everybody should come together that, of course, We will go to the West, but we should know the first ourselves, what resources we had, how we can know them, how we can best utilize them, and how we can enrich our knowledge and skills and enrich our society and our countries. And of course, we will go to the West. So the Hamdard University is 30 kilometers from here, established in the Hamdard Nagar, what we call the city of education, culture, research and culture, city of education, culture and research. And we will try to explore our knowledge that's available within us, available with our friends, available within the Muslim countries, and at the same time, we will go to the West. If we can meet the East and the West, the world peace will come. Unless we do that, world peace will not come. If we run after other people, we will not be able to meet them the way we are supposed to meet them. Otherwise, they will always treat us that we don't have anything, they have everything, and they will undermine our credibility. So we shall have to earn our credibility, then we will go, and that will bring the peace around the whole world. So what I am saying in my speech is that let us look what we have. Let us revitalize our relationship with the Persian world. And I thank Prof again to bring those things, their senses within us, and our universities, our institutions, our research organizations, all of us work together. Hamdard University, there is an open invitation for our foreign guests. If you have time, let us know. We'll take you from here, visit our campus, where the river meet the beautiful sky, where you will find the countryside of Bangladesh, the real Bangladesh, the Jivananda Das Bangladesh. In Bengali we call Jivananda Das. There is a poet who wrote many things about the rural Bangladesh. So if you want to know Bangladesh, please come to the Hamdard campus. You will see it there. And we'll arrange your visit. If you cannot do it today, but one important thing, if you are interested, we are ready. Let us forge our ties in the long relation to do the research, to know Al-Biruni, to know Al-Ibn Sina, and all other knowledge we have, let us discover those. Ladies and gentlemen, I wish every success of this conference, and I hope that our discussions and our conversations will, what I said, is to fill the gap what we have, and of course, enlarge the horizon of our knowledge. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum.